Hello investors, welcome back to the channel. So you guys really enjoyed my last video that I uploaded a couple of days ago of the top stocks to buy right now during this market crash slash pullback. So today I'm going to be showing you guys another six or seven stocks probably that are going to be at a good buy point right now. These are companies that are either affected by the huge issue going on around the world, and you know, these are some, you know, good buying opportunities. Many of the companies are being shut down currently. Production is shut down or they're just stopping things. So these stocks are falling right now and they're having a pullback with the rest of the market pretty much. And there's going to be good buying opportunities in a lot of the sectors currently. So don't forget though, I'm not a financial advisor, so do your own research before investing into any of these. But these companies are definitely looking really good to me, in my opinion, during this market pullback. Now, before we get into the list, I want to thank you guys for over 150 likes from the last video on part one. So this is going to be part two. Let's try to smash that and get 200 likes on this video. So make sure you smash that like button for me. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this and more videos on the stock market. And don't forget, at 5,000 subscribers, we're almost there. We're about 100 subscribers away. I'm having that Amazon giveaway. So make sure you subscribe and make sure you smash that like button. Okay guys, so the number seven stock on our list is going to be JP Morgan Chase. We're going to be looking at JP Morgan Chase. This is an American multinational investment bank and financial services holdings company. It is ranked the largest bank in the United States and the sixth largest in the world by total assets, which estimates around $2.68 trillion. So JP Morgan Chase has been down about 16% since about mid February. So if we look right here, you know, JP Morgan Chase was trading around $138 a share, and then you know, right now it's trading at $116 a share, and it's just been on a downtrend on the 5-day chart. I mean, look right there. So 58-week low 58-week high right there. The PE ratio is really low, which is something I definitely like. It's under 11, so it's about 10.7. The market cap for JP Morgan Chase is $356.9 billion, and then we have a dividend. The dividend is about 3.1%, which is really, really decent, especially for a finance you know, stock like that. 3% dividend, amazing in my opinion. If we look at their dividends, you know, score sheet right here, obviously it's about 90 cents, and if we look at their dividend yield, which is right here, it's been increasing. So it was lower. It was about 2.5%, 2.3%, and it's been growing and growing over time. If we take a look right here on their dividend growth has been right there, years of growth, 9 years. So, I mean, they had some good times right here, but then obviously 2008, everything kind of dropped in 2009 and 10. But then they've been kind of on a recovery slowly, and obviously right now they're paying about $3.30 dividend. You know, that's really nice dividend in my opinion. Their dividend history is great. If we take a look right here, you know, quarterly, they're going like 50 cents, 60 cents, 80 cents right there. And currently we're about 90 cents per quarter. And then their dividend safety, the PE ratio is about 33.29%. You know, it's kind of been consistent. It's been up and down, but not too bad, honestly. JP Morgan Chase, obviously, I really like the finance sector, and I'm actually, oh, by the way, also, I'm probably invested, or I'm going to be invested in most of these stocks, just so you guys know. If you look at my portfolio, JP Morgan Chase, one of my top finance companies. I think I was up about 25% on it, but now with this pullback, it's probably closer to about 10% gain on it. But yeah, JP Morgan Chase is going to be our number seven pick. All right guys, so number six is going to be Nvidia, and Nvidia is an American technology company incorporated in Delaware. It designs graphics processing units for the gaming and professional markets, as well as systems on a chip units for the mobile computing and automotive market. So Nvidia has been trading, you know, at a high. It was around $314 almost, and now we've taken about a 14% loss. So 14%, it's went down in the past maybe 10 to 15 days. Currently we're trading at around $270 per share. But you know, in the 1 month chart we're still up, but then if we look at the 5-day chart, it's just been kind of down and down. One thing to look at, it did go up on Friday. That's one thing to say right there. The 52-week high, you know, $316. 52-week low, $132. PE ratio is a little bit high. It's about 35% or 35. The dividend yield, you know, they have a very low 0.24%. So it's not even a quarter of a percent, pretty much. Very low. But that's not something you would be looking for in Nvidia. But they do have growth. I mean, if we look at the stock, you know, and their value, And when we look at the dividend right now, I mean, obviously it's 0.16%, but dividend growth, you know, years of growth is about 7 years. So obviously it's growing, but it's growing at a very slow rate. But that's not, you know, that's not the reason that people pick NVIDIA as their holding. They're picking it for growth with the chips. They have a lot of chips in the market. You know, they want to grow and help the computer industry pretty much. And they're in, you know, everything is increasing slowly. But yeah, NVIDIA is going to be our number six pick. You know, 14%, it's been down. I feel like this is a good time to get in. I'm probably going to get into this one myself. As well as JP Morgan Chase, like I mentioned, but I believe NVIDIA has nowhere to go except up once all of this settles. Our fifth pick is going to be Boeing, ticker symbol BA. So Boeing, it's an American multinational corporation that designs and manufactures and sells airplanes, rotorcrafts, rockets, satellites, telecommunication equipment, and missiles worldwide, pretty much. You know, Boeing, very big company. On Friday, it was down about $12 or 4.5%. But Boeing is currently down about 18% during this kind of market pullback. So it was trading at around $350 per share at the middle of the month or towards the end of the month. But then now it's just been kind of on a downtrend, and you know, it's down here right now. It's down to $275 a share. 52-week high was $446. 52-week low is pretty much where we're at right now currently almost. P/E ratio around 57. Their dividend yield is almost 3%, so 2.99%, market cap of $154.9 billion. If we take a look at their dividend, you know, the amount is $2.05. If we look at their dividend growth, so the dividend growth, the years of growth is 8 years. This is something I definitely like to see, is the company is growing slowly, but now it's exponentially just rising on up. It's currently paying out around $8.22 per share yearly. You know, great dividend growth. That's something I like to see. If we look at the dividend history is looking pretty nice as well. It's currently, you know, about $2, you know, per share. But the dividend safety for them as well, payout ratio 170%. That's a little extreme, but nothing to worry about with Boeing. Boeing, I think once all this settles, and especially once their airplanes, the 747s, are back up in the air and things get, you know, fixed up, Boeing's definitely going to be back on top. There's nothing to worry about, in my opinion, or at least for me, that's what I'm planning. I think Boeing is a great company, and plus a lot of the airline companies right now are down, so that's another thing you have to look at when you're investing with these type of companies. The number four stock we're going to be looking at today is going to be ticker symbol O, which is Realty Income. So Realty Income is a real estate investment trust that invests in freestanding single tenant commercial properties in the US, Puerto Rico, and the United Kingdom that are subject to NNN lease. So Realty Income, definitely a REIT that I enjoy having in my portfolio. Now, if you guys don't invest in REITs, these are companies that have to pay out around, you know, in the 90% area. They have to pay out 90% of their profits back in, you know, in the form of dividends to the investors. So this is the reason that I invest in Realty Income, and I love having it in my portfolio. I've been adding, you know, for months now, and it was trading at a high around $83. And that was kind of like an extreme price, almost at an all-time high. So now on this pullback, I believe this is a great time for me to buy more Realty Income, because I believe in it long-term, especially now that I'm having a what? It's been down about 12% during this, you know, market crash, I guess you could say. So 12% down. For me, honestly, that's a great time to buy, because I know it's going to come back up in the future. Plus, I'm receiving an amazing dividend. If we look at their PE ratio or PE forward, it's going to be 20.6. And then if we look at their yield, it's a 3.85% dividend yield, almost a 4% dividend on a REIT, especially when it's this cheap, when it's, you know, on this, in my opinion, an extreme sale. I mean, look at that chart. It was, you know, trading consistently, and then boom, just down, straight on down. This, for me, is a great opportunity to buy. Their market cap is $24.8 billion. If we look at their dividend yield, the score sheet, you know, their dividend yield has been increasing. 4-year average yield of 4.36%. You know, it's not that bad at all. If we look at their dividend growth right here, dividend growth, years of growth, 26 years. So this means that for 26 years, they have had consistent, you know, growth in their, you know, dividends. So that is amazing. Currently, you know, they're giving out about 2.7 or $2.70 per share. If we look at their dividend history right here, amazing. You know, I mean, it's consistently going up slowly, obviously, but it's still doing consistent payouts. Dividend safety, payout ratio is about 80%. So that's actually pretty good. They have to, you know, they literally have to do that. So that's a decent thing to look at. But the summary, you know, obviously Realty Income, in my opinion, because REITs are just, in my opinion, one of my favorite things to invest in, especially if you're not investing in like real estate outside and getting like properties. This is another way of kind of being invested in the real estate sector, I guess. So definitely a stock I'm going to be adding. All right, guys. So number three stock we're going to be looking at is going to be CVS. So CVS is an American healthcare company that owns CVS Pharmacy, a retail pharmacy chain, CVS Caremark, which is a pharmacy benefits manager, Aetna, a health insurance provider, and amongst many other brands. So CVS is down about 20% actually in the past, two or three weeks. It's down. It was trading at around $74 a share. Currently, it's trading at $59 a share. You know, it was kind of at an all-time high. PE ratio of about 8, which is very low. I enjoy seeing that. Dividend yield is very nice, 3.38%. I love my dividend yield to be about 3% or higher. Market cap at about $77 billion. The thing is, the health sector is getting really hammered, especially, you know, obviously, with the presidential race coming up, and nobody knows who's going to win, obviously, but United Healthcare has taken a tumble because, you know, obviously Bernie Sanders is trying to go for the free healthcare. So United Healthcare is down extremely right now, just like it was last year when I had that $100 drop, I believe, over a course of a couple of weeks. But it recovered and now it's going back down again. So nobody knows what's going on. But if we look at the dividend score sheet right here, their dividend yield, 4-year average yield about 2.73%. It's kind of increasing slowly, so that's not bad. Dividend growth, their dividend growth is 0 years right there, it says. But, you know, it's been increasing as I can see right here, so it doesn't really look that bad. It's pretty nice. And then dividend history, you know, amazing, 40 cents, 50 cents, just been kind of consistent. I mean, if we look right there, just consistently, you know, staying at about 50 cents. Dividend safety, about payout ratio of about 28%. You know, CVS, I believe this one's going to come back up as well. I mean, it's down 20% right now. If we look at the 5-year chart, we're trading at almost, you know, all-time lows. All-time lows were $51.72. So definitely something I would be looking at. All right, guys. So I know there's a lot of you out there that have been, you know, getting on me about not talking about Facebook lately. But Facebook's going to be our number two pick. I've done some research and I definitely see what you guys are talking about. So obviously, Facebook is an American social media and technology company. In the past 2 weeks, they're down about 11.5%. You know, and anytime Facebook is trading under $200 or around that area, I think it's a good buy for them. They were trading at about $218 and then a 52-week high of $224. They don't have a dividend, obviously. Their PE ratio is about 20.8, almost 21. But if we look at the 5-year chart for Facebook, obviously, it's been going up and down, but right now that it's down 11.5%, I think it's a good time to buy, especially because Facebook doesn't really have that much competition out there, and they're doing many, many, you know, big things right now currently out in the industry. You know, I think Mark Zuckerberg is doing an amazing job, obviously, and I think that Facebook has nowhere to go except up. You know, especially with like Snapchat, you know, they're not as focused as them. Now, Twitter, I do see Twitter as coming up, you know, slowly. Right now, they just had some announcements this week. I know that. But there's not really too much competition out there, with Facebook just being pretty much number one social media out there for everybody to be using. All right, so we left the best for last. Number one stock on my list is going to be Delta Airlines. So Delta Airlines, one of the major airlines of the United States and the legacy carrier. So I think that Delta Airlines, you know, obviously is down right now. A lot of, you know, these airplanes are down, so this, you know, this industry right now is not doing so good because you know, there's not that many flights going into like China and other areas like that. Delta is down about -25% in the past 2 weeks. It was trading at around $58.31, currently trading at $46.13. PE ratio is super low at about 6. That's a super low PE ratio. They have a dividend yield of about 3.49, so 3.5%. Market cap of $29.4 billion. If we look at their dividend right here, their dividend yield obviously average about 2.07%, but it's been increasing, which is good. Right now, it's just been going up, so it has growth. Their dividend growth, years of growth, 6 years. If we look right there, it's been consistently going up every year. And then if we look at their dividend history, obviously they're paying out, they're doing well, and their dividend safety, about 21% payout ratio. But all airline companies right now are down. Last video, I talked about United Airlines, I believe. Right now, I'm talking about Delta Airlines. We even talked about Boeing earlier. But there's just so many other companies like Southwest and other, you know, companies that are doing the same thing. They're all down currently because of this whole situation with the whole world. Obviously, it's trading all the way down here. You know that as soon as all this kind of clears up and once stuff going maybe a quarter or two away by the end of the year, this will be back in the profits. So this is definitely one I'm going to be adding to my portfolio this week as soon as the markets open. So definitely keep an eye out on Delta. All right, guys. So those are my top seven picks right now to buy. This is the part two video. So obviously, if you guys are trying to trade and you guys have never traded, I'm going to have links in the description for Robinhood. Get a free stock when you sign up. And then I'm going to have M1 Finance. You get $10. I get $10 once you fund $100 onto the account. As we can see, the Dow Jones was at about 29,230 points. Currently, it's at about 25,409, and it was even lower than that. It was under 25,000, but we had a kind of like a run up at the end of closing on Friday. But yeah, guys, don't forget to smash that like button for me. Let's get over 200 likes on this video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment below telling me what stocks you're going to be adding to your portfolio in this dip, or if you're buying any at all. And what do you think about this whole controversy and what's going on? Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time.